Allons, Jérôme, best of pantalon. Hello, friends of the French for religion. I am greeting you, no coffee, no workie. Just let me drink some genuine German coffee out of the genuine Thomas Gas mug. If you want one, just go to the description down here and you can order one. It's no problem. So, 2 days ago, I had a post in a video post, a clip on YouTube, describing a little bit the situation for the German ground forces called Bundeswehr in Afghanistan, because they are living hard times. And some of you guys asking me, hey, Thomas, can you bring the same content in English language? I hesitated a little bit because my English is not so perfect, but I have a lot of courage in my heart, like a lion, I think. Sometimes like a lion, sometimes like, yeah, no, not like a lion, you know. Okay. What happened in Afghanistan, all around the actual situation there? Last year, the Trump government had a meeting with the Taliban, and they decided that the US troops should withdraw from Afghanistan not later than April 2021, this year. And on the other hand, the opposite, the Taliban should fulfill three cardinal points, three main points. The first is, they have to hold talks with the government, with the Afghan government. The second is, they have to they stop the war for a certain time. So we call it, in Germany, we call it Waffenruhe, what means no shootings, no attentats, no terrorist attacks for a while. And the third point is that they should not be or carry out operations and work together with any terrorist organization like Al-Qaeda, like IS and others, you know, 3 points. Huh? And what is the deal with the German ground forces? Why is this is interesting for the German ground forces? No, I will talk about this later. So two possibilities for my, no, not three, two possibilities in my option, in my opinion. I think that even Joe Biden will comply with the agreement with the Taliban and he will withdraw his troops in April. What does it mean? The Taliban would say, okay, the US troops has left our country, no boots on the ground. We will not fulfill our agreement, because there's no need to. Why should we? Nobody's here, no strangers are here. And then, okay. Or even Joe Biden decides that he will leave his troops in Afghanistan. What means for the Taliban? They will be very angry and they will say, okay, the US government did not fulfill his agreement with us. And now we will attack all soldiers, foreign soldiers in our country. Also the soldiers of the Bundeswehr. Okay, what does it mean for the Bundeswehr? Because the Bundeswehr, the German ground forces, they have a mission called Resolute Support, running in with headquarters in Kunduz and partially also in Khor Marmal in Mazar-i-Sharif. Resolute Support is NATO-led, and the aim of Resolute Support is to instruct the Afghan security forces and defense forces, you know, the ANA, Armée Nationale Afghane. So they train the soldiers in very different domains, and this is a very, very scary situation. When the US troops pull out in April this year from Afghanistan, the German troops are really in trouble, because the German government decided that they will stay there until the end of the year, until the end of this year, to fulfill and go on with Resolute Support. What does it mean? The Taliban also said by different links that if the Germans will not pull out of the country, anyway, any foreign army, any foreign soldier will not pull out of the country, April, they will attack them. And I think the statement of the Taliban should be taken very seriously. And why is it cranios for the German soldiers? Because I think that the German soldiers, they are good soldiers, you know, but a Taliban, he's a guerrilla fighter. Taliban is a partisan. They when they are 10 years old, 11 years old, they have the Kalashnikov near to the bed. They are fighters. And the Germans are not in this way. And the Taliban are fighting for their country, for their ideal, for their people. So they will not leave any centimeter for foreign troops. And I think it should, in my opinion, the German soldiers should pull out of Afghanistan very soon, before end of April 2021, because the situation is too heavy to bear. It's not good. And the government stated, no, we stay there, Resolute Support will go on, because we had a lot of success in the past. But this is not my opinion. This is not my opinion, because you must understand that the soldiers, they train the security forces, and the soldiers from the defense forces, they train, they are Afghan people. They are poor, they have families. And when they come to the training every day in Mazar-i-Sharif, in Komamal, or to Kunduz, okay, they say, okay, we are here, we're training with you. But, and they say, yes, everything's okay, they're nice, they're smiling. But every time they are out of the camp, finished with the instruction for the day, they wear another face. And we will never understand the people there, never, never, never. And there's no reason for nobody, for no foreign troop to stay in Afghanistan. And this is my opinion. You know, this is my opinion. And for that's why I say German troops has to pull out of Afghanistan as quick as possible until it's too late. You know, it could be too late very, very soon. I made some notice here. I have to see what I have to tell you other things. Otherwise, allons, girons, baisse ton pantalon. Yeah, that's it. Okay. Yeah. Natural regime. Yes, and then the German government stated that, okay, we will stay there, we will go on with Resolute Support, and if necessary, we can pull in with 1,000, 2,000, 3,000 more troops, fighting troops, maybe tanks, maybe parachutists, to protect the instructions of Resolute Support. But this for me is bullshit, because when the Taliban will or have in the head, have the aim to attack the German ground forces, they will do so, and they will do it on a hard way. And if you have 1,000, 2,000 or 3,000 soldiers, ground forces, German ground forces there, will not change the situation, you know. And let me tell you that the British army tried to pacify the country without success. The Russians have had the lessons learned from their intervention in Afghanistan. So if you the French tried to invade Indochina, Vietnam, it was not a success. The US troops tried to intervene in Vietnam. Was bullshit, it was not good. You know, when you fight as a foreign troop in a foreign country, you will never win, even with ground forces, boots on the ground, or by airstrikes, or the two in combinated ways. Never, you will never have a success, because the people defending their country. Yeah, and we have to leave Afghanistan to the Afghans. It's their country, and if they need solutions to change the regime, to change their way of life, it must come from internal. They need to change their country. Their people have to intervene to do and to make things better. It's not up to us. We have nothing to do in Afghanistan. We had nothing to do in Vietnam, in Indochina, nor we have something to do in Algeria, talking for the French people. That's the way. That's the point. We should stop war. It's not good. We should involve more economically to build up bridges, to build whatever, to make the country more sure for education, for building, for electricity, for water, yes, for health, yes, but not with weapons. There is no military solution in Afghanistan today, and there will no be any military solution in Afghanistan next year, or in 10 years, or in 20 years. nor is it in Iran. Never. This is what we have to think over. So let me tell you that for the actual situation in Afghanistan is that the German ground forces cannot move. They cannot move with on the roads because it's too dangerous. They have to, when they go from A to B to Z, they do it by helicopter, mostly by helicopter. This is more sure. And if your main reason to be there is to protect yourself, this is not a reason to be there, because you have to have a mission to carry out. If you have more to do to protect yourself, to protect the soldier, protect the camp, then carry out or conduct the operations and the mission. It's not good. Why are they there? And it's no reason. And we had about 59 German soldiers died in Afghanistan since the war. ISAF and then also Resolute Support. And it's not worth the case. It's never worth the case. Not one life is worth the case. And it should stop there. And I think it's better for us to withdraw under these conditions. Because the main mission cannot be carried out any longer. And that's it. That's the point. So we also must see the reasons why we pushed in with troops in Afghanistan. Normally it was September 11, you know, the attacks on the Twin Tower, World Trade Center in New York. But then Bush talked about an act of evil, and he sent his troops everywhere in all countries, foreign countries where he has seen the acts of evil, and there were also has been Afghanistan, and I think it's not true anymore. It's not good anymore, because I think it's more to avoid that China and Russians had influence in these countries. That's why they show up there to say no, we are America, the greatest nation on earth. It's our influence, you know, it's our terrain, you know, and it's of course also for economical reason and for political strategical reasons, but not for September 11. I think this is bullshit. We have not to defend our home in a foreign country. This is not good anymore. We have to make a new mindset. A new mindset. The mindset should always be, we have one earth, we live all together, and the future will bring a lot of challenges to us, even if it's the climate change is a very big problem to come, and we have seen corona could be more behind, you know, new mutations of the coronavirus. We have a lot of challenges in this earth, and we should stop make war, we should stop bringing weapons to other countries. We should stop acting as enemies, one each other. It's not good anymore. I'm not here to say make love, not war, but it's a little bit this one. Okay.